Hey everyone, this is Edward, and I would like to welcome you to this version of the Advanced Law Student Learning Series. And today we are going to cover Bayliner Marine Corps versus Crow. So let's get right down to it. Let's see. Again, this text is available here in the description. And let's see, of course, we are in the Supreme Court of Virginia. And let's go to the general overview. So we are going to talk about the format here, and we're going to break it down as we go along. But just to give you an overview, so we're still under offer, and here the author of the book, the Farnsworth book, wants to make some assumptions. So it's going to assume that you know what an express warranty is, how that is created. And it's also going to assume that you know that it can be part of the offer. And here in section 7 below, we're going to cover more of the key words and those terms of art that you need for your exam. But again, this is just an overview, and there's going to be two elements here. And the first one is that a relation must exist between what is represented by the seller and what is purchased by the buyer. And we're going to get more into the definition of seller and the buyer as we explore this case. And also, opinions or commendations cannot form an express warranty. So let's talk about these in further detail. Let's look at the main headings. So, applicable law. When you write your exam, you want to mention whether you're under the common law or the Uniform Commercial Code. That is going to be very important. Here, we are going to be under the UCC because there are goods involved, the boat. Contract formation stage, we're still under the offer. We haven't gotten to acceptance yet. So just know for now that an express warranty can be formed at this time, at the contract formation stage, as part of the offer. Now we're going to look at these terms a little bit more closely. Applicable law again. So you must know that for the sale of goods, that usually the Uniform Commercial Code will usually apply. The common law will apply to services or when there is real property involved, the purchase of. So we are under the UCC. Now let's focus on this a bit further. Contract formation stage, offer. Then again, the authors of the textbook are going to assume that you know how express warranty is made. And we're going to cover that more under section 7 of this material. But here we are going to discuss a couple of the elements there. Now, the whole case is based on allegations of the buyer, and he is claiming that the seller made express warranties that the boat could achieve a maximum speed of 30 miles per hour. So that's the issue, that the seller's offer included an express warranty regarding the speed of the boat. Again, acceptance is not an issue here. And also no issue, there is no issue here of whether an offer was formed. We're not going to touch on these other terms yet because that's not relevant to the class discussion. Let's go on to section 5. Let's go to key notes from this case. So let's just go to what the buyer states. So he does state that the seller made some warranties, and there are two sources of that allegation. We're going to call those number 1 and number 2. So the first text is those pro matrices, and that's just a listing of the boat models. And the second one is a brochure. Now here it says that it was made by the manufacturer, and that's fine. But we're just going to refer to the manufacturer and the other parties that are part of this defense. We're going to call them the seller. And of course, Crow, the plaintiff, we're going to call him the buyer. Let's go ahead and now go to that listing. Now, when you approach the these cases, you always want to know what the law is. What is the law? So let's look at it. What's the rule? Let's look at that first. And it's stated right here. And let's go ahead and translate. Again, let's translate these terms into buyer and seller. So Bayliner, we're gonna call that. We're gonna call that party here the seller. So let's see how this looks. Okay, so if we transform this into a rule, let's do that now. So let's see now. So the representations of the seller did not relate to the particular goods that were purchased by the buyer. So you see how now we have our law right there. And in this case, they're talking about, of course, the propellers. So again, you know that term, if you want to talk about apples, but you can't mix apples and oranges. So that's what's happening here. That is what the buyer is saying. Hey, look, we're talking about apples, but then we have oranges. So just make that analogy, and that's what's happening here. So this is one of the holdings, and since the representations that the seller made were not related to the goods bought by the buyer, and then the court said that there was no warranty that was made as part of the offer. And let's go. So again, get this book and read this closely, because you do want to see how we derive that rule from the holding and from the facts. Let's go on to the second source, the manufacturer's sales brochure. Let's look again. Let's look at the rule. What does the rule say? I want to know. So this right here is actually codified as part of the UCC. Opinions or commendations of goods do not create a warranty. Commendation, of course, is just praise. So opinions or commendations do not create a warranty. And also, you also have to know this, that in order for it to be a commendation, and if it does not describe a specific characteristic or feature of the boat, then it's probably a commendation. It's not, that probably will not fall under the category of a warranty. So if the statements made by the seller do describe a specific characteristic, and then you may have a warranty there. It's possible. So let's look at what the statements of the seller. And he says that this model boat delivers the kind of performance you need to get to the prime offshore fishing grounds. So does that make a specific characteristic or feature of the boat? And the answer is no. And again, the court said that no express warranty was created from that statement. Applicable law, this case did use the Virginia version of the UCC, and they're pretty much aligned, so you don't have to compare the rules. And again, I did say earlier that for the exams, you do have to mention if the common law or the UCC applies. That is one thing you do have to mention in your exams. You don't have to mention the specific code, but you do have to state whether UCC or common law apply. All the warranties, implied warranties. Now, the Farnsworth text states that implied warranties of merchantability and fitness was left for another day and in a different chapter. And we're going to do the same here. We're going to leave it for another day. The holding for the exam purpose. So again, you want to get good at just summarizing the holding in one sentence. Now here there was two of them. Let's go to the holding number one. An express warranty is not created when the representations of the seller do not relate to the goods that the buyer purchases. So that's coming straight from the case. Holding number two, an express warranty is not created when the seller merely states an opinion or gives a commendation of the goods. So that's holding number two, and this is again part of the UCC. Now let's go ahead and go to section seven, and here's the law for express warranty. You do need to know this, and this is how an express warranty is created. And again, it is part of the bargain process that takes place under the offer. And let's see now, part two. Here it is right here, the codified. The seller's opinion or commendation of the goods does not create a warranty. Now this is the rule from the case. An express warranty is not created when the representations of the seller do not relate to the goods that the buyer purchases. So that's something you want to remember. And also you want to remember that an opinion or a commendation will not include specific features. And we talked about that earlier in the holding, so you do want to get that as well. And that's the end of this case. And again, section 8, download this ebook on contracts, and it's more thorough as far as the overall picture. So I hope this helped, and best of luck on your exams. Until soon.